The University of Arizona is leading a NASA mission to gather a sample from the asteroid Bennu. This week, the mission reached a critical stage, selecting the exact site where scientists hope to collect 2 ounces of the asteroid and bring it back to Earth in 2023. The mission and its many partners have planned, designed, and studied the characteristics of their asteroid for nearly 2 decades. Lockheed Martin in Denver spent more than 10 years designing the instrument that will actually contact Bennu to acquire the material.
We are looking for spots that have 2 centimeter size particles and smaller. And so we're hoping that we're not going to have a whole lot of very large objects, because obviously a very large object is not going to fit inside the TAGSAM head. We think that the head will be in contact with the asteroid for about 5 seconds. The heart of the mission occurs in 5 seconds out of 14 years.
5 years ago, when that interview was filmed, the mission had a very specific idea of what scientists thought they'd find upon arrival at Bennu last December. After a year of close-up observations and characterizations of the asteroid's physical and chemical properties, they learned this is not the Bennu of all their planning.
When we arrived at Bennu, we really anticipated having a much smoother surface. A lot of the data that we had when we characterized it based on ground-based data really gave us the interpretation that we would have a lot of fine-grained material. There's not a lot of beachfront property on Bennu right now. One of the things that we've had to do in response to seeing that the surface is so rugged, so much more rugged than we anticipated, is we had to sharpen our pencils and change the way that we're going to navigate to the surface a bit. We are using natural feature tracking as our guidance navigation system to the surface.
This will be the first time that NASA is using natural feature tracking to navigate around a small celestial body. The spacecraft will basically use pictures of the surface to generate its own map to the sample sites. To call the surface rugged is an understatement. Some boulders are taller than a 3-story house. That presents safety concerns for the approach to tagging the asteroid for sample collection and the subsequent retreat back to orbit. All these challenges get thorough examinations and science team meetings.
So the spacecraft is able to wave off an approach to tag if the place it's going is marked as hazardous. Right, so we make a mask of places that you would not want to touch, and the spacecraft is able to say, I'm too close to one of those, I'm going to leave. And so there's what we're calling back-away hazards, which combines several different things. Basically, after we tag, the spacecraft could tip over somewhat, and then it just backs straight away from wherever it's going. And so we're looking at things it could crash into in any several ways.
So it is not the asteroid that we designed the spacecraft to go and sample, but we expected the unexpected. So we built a lot of capability, a lot of redundancy, and a lot of time at the asteroid, and all of that was put into the mission plan. You have to expect the unexpected when you're going out on an expedition like that.
Some of those capabilities comes from the mission's camera suite called OCAMS, which has been performing flawlessly. The entire surface of Bennu has been photographed and closely analyzed. Those images will be crucial to determining the final sample sites.
This week, actually, on Saturday, we will be acquiring data of those 4 candidate sample sites, and this will be at a higher resolution by about a factor of 3 to 4 from what we have currently. And so having that data is going to allow us to determine between those 4 sites which among them appears to be the best. And so it's a relative assessment. We will be able to see an object the size of a pickle in the candidate sample sites from the Recon A imaging that starts next week.
Each site will be judged on the spacecraft's ability to safely access the surface, the abundance of 2 centimeter or smaller material the spacecraft could scoop up, and science value of the sample, specifically the presence of organics and water-bearing minerals.
The OSIRIS-REx mission has just completed the Recon A phase, which is getting up-close looks at the final 4 sample sites, and the data are phenomenal. We have a lot of information,
each site is unique and challenging and intriguing in its own way, so it's not an obvious decision on which direction we're going to go, but we have the information that we need to make the right choice on both the primary and the backup sample site.
After the two final choices are made, several more months of study will reveal objects as small as a penny.
So we're measuring something that's about 10 centimeters across, and we need to know the abundance of 2-centimeter scale rocks. We will be getting that kind of information as we go into Recon B and ultimately Recon C, where we're getting pixel scales of 3 millimeters, which is really unprecedented to characterize an asteroid surface at that scale. As we get into 2020, we're going to be going down to a couple of hundred meters from the surface of the asteroid, so a factor of 5 times closer than we've been in the Recon A sorties. We are looking to announce the sample site at the American Geophysical Union in San Francisco on December 12th.
That announcement of the primary and secondary sample site took place in San Francisco this past Thursday.
So the winner of the OSIRIS-REx Site Selection Championship is the Nightingale site.
All right.
Sample collection is scheduled for August 2020. To learn more about the OSIRIS-REx mission, including more images of Bennu, visit asteroidmission.org.